Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to cover what to expect from an Msbi developer having 5 to 8 years of experience. This video not only for job seekers and also for hiring managers and recruitment firms that what they can expect from the candidates. Let's begin. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's start discussing about skill set required for 5 to 8 years of experience MSBI developer. The first and foremost skill is expert level in SQL and expert in data warehousing concepts and also implementation. Why? Because the core concept of MSBI is to develop or implement the data warehousing solution in any one of the database. So for that, you need to know the concepts along with the database. It is to develop in the database level. So you should be aware of all the SQL and database concepts. This is the foremost important thing. As a 5 to 8 years experience guy is going to be a team leader or a senior software engineer, so he should be having more on conceptual and to implement any new project, any complex project. Then there comes SSIS, and it should be expert in the SSIS and also mention ADF, because as the organizations are going towards Azure, so you should be familiar with ADF. Then expert level in SSIS, expert level in MDX, experts. I mentioned expert in green here. This is the core difference between a person having 2 to 5 years experience and 5 to 8 years experience. So you should be expert, but a candidate below experience than you should be aware of these technologies, or may not aware, and you should be in a position to teach them. So in this way, you should be having very good knowledge on all these technologies, MSBI, because you are in a position to lead the team. If you do not know any one of them, then your team will not know it. You cannot succeed in the project. So that is why I mentioned everything in MSBI, right from SQL, data warehousing, SSIS, AAS, and SSRS, you should be expert of. Then when it comes to SSAS, I mentioned for the people having 2 to 5 years experience, it is optional multidimensional tabular. In case of 5 to 8 years experience, you should be aware of both, because when it comes to different design of your implementing your project, you should be able to guide or direct in a proper way whether this can be achieved in a multidimensional or tabular. So this is the thing, but nevertheless, Microsoft is recommending everything can be achieved in tabular. There are some projects or some requirements that can be achieved only in multidimensional. In those cases, we'll go for it. Then intermediate knowledge on Power BI. So you should have knowledge on Power BI. It is not like basic knowledge, are you aware of Power BI? You should be having a working knowledge on Power BI. So this is the core or skills required for a MSBI developer having 5 to 8 years experience. And also the one important thing is like you should have Azure technologies. As the organizations are moving towards Azure, everything together, Azure Analysis Service and ADF, everything you should be aware of, even in SQL, Azure SQL as well. As we are familiar with this architecture, as you can see, the ultimate aim of MSBI is to build a data warehouse using the SSIS and then build cubes for pre-aggregation layer, then for reporting SSRS and Power BI. So in order to have a complete MSBI developer for a senior resource having 5 to 8 years experience, you should be thorough in this concept, the entire flow of BI, like what sources you should be extracting, different methods you can apply for, and either SSIS or ADF is suitable. Now, the modern architecture is a combination of your on-premise and the cloud technologies. So for that, you should be ready enough to handle such scenarios as well. So in case of SQL, these are the skills you should be aware of. The things I highlighted in green, this makes you the things you should be extraordinary performer than the resource having less CS experience. Advanced SQLs like pivoting, unpivoting, even it is not those who are having 2 to 5 years experience, they should not learn this. I'm not saying that, but if a person having senior most should also aware of all these things: column store indexing, windowing functions, pivot, unpivot, whatever the complex things that can be achieved in SQL in terms of performance improvement, everything together. You cannot have any excuses. That is what I want to make here. Then in case of data warehousing implementation, the core concepts remain same. You might aware of what are the different fact dimensions, types of dimensions, slowly changing dimensions, and implemented end-to-end data warehousing solution. You should aware of staging and ODS concepts and the granularity, because only if you know what is granularities and other things, you can have design the data warehouse. So basically, you should be ready to design the dimensional modeling and handling addition of new dimension. If some changes comes to your existing data warehouse, how to handle it, whether it is, some one of the example is if addition of a new dimension. So this requires some kind of tricky things, how you can handle it. So these kind of stuffs you should be aware of: repopulate historical data mart or new logic. So these are some examples. I'm highlighting it to you. So you should be familiar of handling in case of data warehousing implementation. Security access. There comes ETL tool. In case of ETL, it is more or less same like 2 to 5 years experience people, those who have. In addition, you should be very much strong in deployment, like designing ETL flows. There can be like control flows. Design ETL flows is like there might be a dependencies from one package to another, and you should be controlling the entire project. So you should aware which task should run first, followed by other tasks, right? So these are the things I'm saying about you should be aware of: identify dependencies and package protections. In case of data flows, what task you should use. You should also able to highlight what task that should not be used. So only if you are expert level, you can say like which task is performant efficient, this will kill the performance. So in that manner, you should be equipped with. In case of deployment, you should aware of environment, parameters, reports, and troubleshooting, how to generate SSIS reports while running the package, which packages failed. So these things is very similar. As I said before, it is not mandatory like only you should have. People having less experience or should also have this knowledge as well. But for you, it is mandatory. In case of SSIS, multidimensional, you can have additional knowledge of proactive caching, partitions, processing types, performance tuning. In case of tabular model, rollover security, and for DAX, you should be intermediate to advanced level knowledge. In case of SSRS, all these things, having basic knowledge on SSRS, and along with that, you should have a catch sheet reports, report manager, deployment, page native reports knowledge as well. Power BI intermediate. So you should be aware of all the Power BI core concepts of modeling, relationship, Power Query, and deployment, then data flows. So if you want, you can take a snapshot of this. This is the entire snapshot of the what are our requirements, what are the different topics you need to aware of for a person having 5 to 8 years experience, and these are the different topics. And also, as I mentioned before, you should have knowledge on Azure technologies as well. Where you can learn most of the topics like SSIS, SSAS, data warehousing concept, SQL, all these things are available in the Analytics with Nags channel. We will share the description below, except the SSRS. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.